Let's go. Come on. Nettie. Play. Welcome back to VBS at Mount Moriah. Are you glad you're here? Somebody say what? Yeah, loud. I'm glad you're here tonight. We're going to get started out by doing our pledges. We're going to have a lot of fun. We got some things at the end of the Bible school to tell you. That'll be some good prizes for you. And it will be exciting, all right? Did you have a good time last night?
Yeah.
Good. Boy, that's not good. Did you have a good time last night?
Yeah.
That's better. We want some excitement, all right? All right, we're going to stand. This is Mr. Danny. Mr. Danny's going to come and lead us in the pledges and the songs tonight. So let's be very reverent. And when he says attention, what do? A salute. Everybody do it, okay? And let's be very, very pay attention. And let's be very, very reverent because this flag is special. This flag is special. And this Bible is special, all right? So you can hold. Okay, Mr. Danny.
All right. Tonight, we're having a little bit of technical difficulties, so you don't see the screens up there. How many knows all this by heart? You know the pledges by heart?
Yes.
All right, then. That's what we're going to try to do this morning. I mean, tonight. I probably don't know them by heart. So let's do the pledge to the American flag. Attention. Salute. Pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
My country, 'tis of thee.
Nettie.
My country, 'tis of thee, sweet land of
time for the Christian flag. Attention, salute, pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the Christian flag and to the Savior for whose kingdom it stands, one Savior, crucified, risen, and coming again with life and liberty for all who believe.
All right, stand up for Jesus.
Stand up for Jesus. Soldiers on the cross lift high his royal banner. It must not suffer loss from victory unto victory. His army he shall lead. Fill every foe with vanquish. And Christ is Lord in thee.
All right, now it's time for the Bible. Attention, salute, pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the Bible, God's holy word. I will make it a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. And I will hide its words in my heart that I may not sin against God.
B-I-B-L-E.
The B-I-B-L-E. Yes, that's the book for me. I stand upon the word of God. The B-I-B-L-E.
Bye.
BLE. Yes, that's the book for me. I stand upon the Word of God, the BIBLE Bible.
All right, let's be dismissed in prayer, and then you can go with your, what do you call them, coaches, teachers, leaders. Go, the team leaders. All right, let's have word prayer. Everybody bow your heads. Let's have word prayer, and then we'll split up and do our thing tonight, and we're going to have a great time, all right? Let's pray. Father, we love you. Thank you for those who came out tonight. I pray, Lord, you bless us again. We had some professions of faith last night, and Lord, that's all we can do is plant the seed. You water, let God give the increase. Bless these boys and girls tonight. Bless our leaders. Lord, stop the attacks of Satan. He fights us all the time. And I pray, Lord, you give us a good time tonight. Bless everyone that's working in it. In Jesus' name, amen. Have a good time, guys. Here you go, sir.
Brother Danny, you seen the preacher? Have you seen the preacher? I heard him. I go, listen. Preacher?
Ain't nobody seen him. I seen him going down the
preacher.
Road.
Preacher!
I seen him going
these
down.
These children are out here looking at me and it's scary. It's so scary.
I seen him going down the road pushing a wheelbarrow while ago.
Colvin, is that you?
Who? Hey. Who's laughing?
Preacher, can you come? Because these children is scaring me.
Yeah, I can. Hey. You don't have to be scared. I'm here. Don't worry about it. Who are you anyway?
I'm Nancy.
Nancy. Nice to meet you, Nancy. But we got to finish this.
Nice to meet you. You awful nice looking.
Well, we got to finish this thing up tonight.
Oh,
okay.
We got one more night.
I know, but we got to finish this night. So whatever you're needing to do.
He scares me.
You're wearing me. Tell her bye.
Tell Nancy bye. Bye, all you children. Bye, all you children.
I don't even know where she came from. Does anybody know her? All right, never mind. All right, here we go. Have you had a good time so far?
Yeah!
Did you have a good time last night?
Yeah!
All right, now, after this is over tonight, we're going to ask some questions. I got two or three little gifts I want to give away. But you got to remember some stuff from last night, too. Okay? Then you got to remember stuff from tonight, all right? Then I'll ask two or three questions. You answer them, and then you can come up and get your little prize, okay? All right? Now, if you are, and I want you to listen to me, okay? We're getting ready to have another skit, and it's really going to be good. And I want you to pay close attention. Don't have anything in your hands. Everything in your hand, put it down. Okay? Sit back. All the way back against the seat. Okay? Take your hands and do like this. And keep them that way. All right? Now, if you'll do that for me for just a few minutes, at the end of this thing, I'm going to tell you something, how you can earn a pretty good prize for tomorrow night. And I'm telling you, you're going to like it, okay? We had a good crowd last night. Had about 50. We got about 42 tonight. So that's really a good crowd. So I thank you for being here tonight. Now, I want to introduce this reporter. She's going to interview the richest man in the world tonight, okay? So I'm going to introduce, this is Miss Izzy. I want you to give her a big hand as she comes in tonight. Thank you for being with us tonight. We certainly do appreciate it. You give her your attention now, okay, for just a few minutes.
Hi. Tonight I'm going to interview the richest man alive, Jimmy and his lovely wife, Charlene. pretty good. Okay, so I hear you're the richest man alive. How does that feel?
Well, have you ever seen any paparazzi around you? Yeah, that's pretty much my life every day.
How do you feel to be married to this man?
It's nice. I like the cameras.
Do you love them?
Yeah.
Okay, so what is your net worth?
I think last time I checked, it's like maybe a little over $45 billion. Not much.
I checked this morning, and I think it's $50 billion.
Oh.
That is a lot of money. How much do you donate to charity per week, you'd say?
I say we just knock off $1 million about every month.
That is a lot of money. How many buildings do you own?
I think last time I lose track, but I've got like over 1,000.
How many vehicles?
A lot.
Like number wise, I think it's like 769 of them, but we don't drive them every day.
We hire people to come drive them for us and keep them up.
Ever riding a limo?
All the time.
What does the inside of your house look like?
Well, have you ever been inside the White House?
No, I have not.
Well, it's basically like the White House, but 10 times bigger.
How do you even get around in that house?
By Sedgways.
Do you have to, like, drive a golf cart from place to place?
Yeah, pretty much. We've got different quarters of the house that we drive around to that we have to because it's just too much of a walk to walk around. So we've got maids and stuff that clean the house and everything.
And what do you do on a daily basis?
Sit by the pool, watch our stocks go up, you know, the wife things.
I do have one question, though. What is your opinion on the Lord?
I do good things, like I donate and I give money to charities and churches and stuff, and I think that's only way I can get into heaven, and I do the goods, and I follow the Ten Commandments and stuff, and yeah.
Who really needs them if you have all that money, right?
Listen to your story, and here's a problem that I've got with it, okay? Now, I'm the preacher here, and we're having this interview with these boys and girls, but we want you to know the truth, okay?
Okay.
Now, Jimmy, you can have all the money there is to have in the entire world. In the Bible, you familiar with the Bible? You know anything about the Bible?
Yeah.
Okay. And you said you kept the Ten Commandments.
Mm-hmm.
Nobody's ever kept the Ten Commandments.
Yeah, but I have. I make sure I give charity money to churches and donate to churches and everything.
Okay, let me tell you this about this guy in the Bible. He was rich, probably rich as you are. And he came to Jesus and he said, "What can I do to go to heaven?" And Jesus said, "Keep the Ten Commandments." You know what he said? Like you, he said, "I've kept all these from my youth up. I've kept all of them. I'm almost perfect." And Jesus said one thing, Charlene, that you lack. You know what it was? Jesus said, "Sell everything you've got and give it away and follow me. Let me become your Savior." You know what that guy did? He wouldn't do it. You know why? Because his money was worth more to him than Jesus. And I'm going to tell you something, Jimmy. And you all need to think about this. Your money will not get you into heaven. And you need to know that. And I'm just telling you the truth. Jesus Christ came, shed his blood, gave his life. And if you could get into heaven because you kept the Ten Commandments or because you had all that money, Jesus wouldn't have to come and die. Have you ever heard the story about Jesus dying on the cross?
Yeah.
Do you believe it? Okay, yeah. Why did he come? He comes so me and you could be saved. If I could keep the commandments or my money to get me into heaven, then we'd just go to heaven. We didn't need Jesus. But you can't do that. You understand that?
Mm-hmm.
And okay. Jesus told him, said, if you'll sell everything, give it all away and follow me and let me be your Savior, then you can go to heaven. You understand that?
Yes, preacher.
So if Jesus said that to you tonight, sell everything you've got, y'all sell it all, give it all up, let me be your Savior, let me come in your heart and be your Savior, trust me, believe on me, believe that I died for you, realize you're sinners and on your way to hell, realize Jesus gave his life for you. If Jesus told you that, would you give it up and follow him?
After the story you said, then yeah, I would.
Because your money's not going to get you there. Would you do that? That's what Jesus told us to do. And in this story in Luke chapter number 18, that guy wouldn't do it. And you know what the Bible said he did? Boys and girls, you know what the Bible said about this man in the Bible? Listen to me. I don't want you to talk. Just like I talked to Jimmy and them right now. Do you know what that rich man done that night? The Bible say he went away sad. You know why he went away sad? Because he thought his money would get him into heaven. Jimmy, your money won't get you into heaven. What'll get you into heaven?
God.
Jesus Christ. Believing on him. What will get you into heaven?
Getting saved.
Getting saved by God's grace. What would get you into heaven, Miss Izzy?
Following God's word.
Following God's word and getting saved by God's grace. So boys and girls, let me tell you tonight. Last night we had our service, and after the service was over, I asked any boys and girls that want to get saved, if you hang around after the service, we'll meet with you, we'll talk to you, come find the leaders, come find the workers, come find me, Miss Mary. We will talk with you and we'll show you how to get saved. Boys and girls, you can't work your way to heaven. You cannot buy your way into heaven. There's no way you can get into heaven but the Lord Jesus Christ. All right? So we wanted to share that story with you tonight. Let's have a word of prayer, okay? And Father, we love you. We thank you tonight, Lord, for this time together. I thank you, Lord, for Izzy and Coven and Liliana, Lord, and the skit they put on tonight. Lord, I pray these boys and girls will get a hold of this truth that Jesus Christ is the only way, and he is the only way to heaven. And Lord, maybe tonight there might be a little boy or a little girl here that their heart's tender and they don't want to go to hell. They want to be saved by your grace. I pray tonight the Holy Spirit will deal their heart and they'll get born again. Thank you for all the boys and girls here tonight. Thank you for all the workers and the leaders. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Let's give them a big hand. Amen. Thank you, guys. That's awesome. Thank you. Isn't that good? Isn't that really, really good? And what you heard tonight really is a story from, listen, hold on a minute. Oh, sit down. Look here. What's this? What do you do? Listen. You listen. Okay, so listen. When I do this, now if I do this, I can't hear you, but if I do this, there's a difference. If I do that, so that means listen, okay? So what I need you to do right now is listen. The story we told you tonight is in the Bible. That man came to Jesus. Look at me. That man came to Jesus, and he wanted to go to heaven. And you know what? He didn't go to heaven. You know what happened to him? He wouldn't sell everything he had. He wouldn't follow the Lord. And he died and went to hell. And boys and girls, the most important thing you'll ever do in life is get saved and follow the Lord Jesus Christ. All right? Y'all ready to have some fun now? All right, let's hit the floor. Come on, Brother Danny. Y'all got to help us here. So here we go. Here we go. Y'all read that? Can y'all read that? What does it say? Okay, now, here's how it's going to go. Brother Danny's going to lead us off, and we're going to do the motions. Y'all help us in. Miles? Come on, Miles. Miles knows all the motions. He knows all. Come right here in the middle, Miles. Miles knows all the motions to this song. Okay, you can help us, Miss Nancy. All right. Now, we're going to start out real slow. And then we're going to get faster and faster and faster and faster. And by the time you get done, you're going to be going so fast, your head's going to be swimming. You ready? All right, Mr. Danny, lead us off in this.
The Lord's army.
No, 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 that's not right. I mean they were marching the infantry.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah, we got we'll do it.
You go ahead and leave.
Okay, sir.
No.
You gotta give me a good key.
There we go.
Give us a good key, Nick.
I may never
march in the infantry slow. Think you can do it faster than that? Okay, Mr. Danny, we can try one more time, maybe. You ready?
Ready?
I may never march in the cavalry, shoot the artillery. Where's my piano player at? She quit?
Where's the piano?
I may never march in the infantry, ride in the cavalry, shoot the artillery. I may never march in the infantry, but I'm in the Lord's army. Yes, sir. I'm in the Lord's army. Yes, sir. I'm in the Lord's army. Yes, sir. I may never march in the infantry, ride in the cavalry, shoot the artillery. I may never zoom on the enemy, but I'm in the Lord's army. Yes, sir. Yeah, good job. Y'all be seated. Y'all be seated. Bye, Nancy. Yeah, that's it. All right. Let me see what I got back here. If y'all be real quiet, I might have something. You gonna do about four of these? Okay. That's pretty good. That's pretty good. Me and Brother Danny's tired. We're tired. Okay. Miss Kim, somebody. Coven, come here. Since Brother Coven, Miss Little, come here. I need y'all to help me a minute. Stand right down here. Put your horse down, Melly. Put the horse down. I'm going to flush her down the toilet. Anyway. All right, here we go. You may know what them are.
Any Skittles.
Oh. Okay. We're going to do M&M's first. Now. All right. Sit still. Sit down. I'm going to ask you a question. All right. First one to raise your hand. Y'all got to watch. Help me, okay? Me and Danny's too tired to see who's raising their hand. Don't raise your hand yet. Okay. Now, last night was our first night. Right? Keep your hand down. Does anybody know who told Adam and Eve? Hold on. Let me finish my. Who told Adam and Eve it was okay to eat that fruit? Which one? That's the little boy right here? The Wyatt? Okay, who told him? The devil did. That's right. Come here, son. The devil sure did. All right, good job. All right. Yeah, good idea. Do not open the candy in here. Okay, keep it closed till you get in your car, and then you scatter it in your car. Yeah, I'm just kidding, huh? Riding me, you better keep it closed. All right, Skittles. Now, keep your seat. Must keep an eye out. Put your hands down. Sit down. Sit down. Sit down, Joplin. Sit down. Miles, if you don't sit down, you're going home, man. You won't like it. Good. All right, here we go. What was the punishment for Adam and Eve after they ate the fruit? Who, guys? Okay. Which one? One of those three. Okay, Addie. What was the punishment for Adam and Eve after? That's right. Come on. Come on. Come on. Okay. Good job, Addie. Got two more. This ain't bad. Ah. Okay, now listen. You got to win them. And this is because you listen and you get rewarded for that, okay? Now, do you remember them two coming out? Yeah. You remember them coming out? Don't raise your hand yet. Well, don't raise your hand yet. Remember him coming out? I'm just seeing if you're listening. What was his name? Which one? Tonight. Oh, I'm talking about tonight. Which, that little girl in the blue. All right, what was his name? Jimmy, that's right. At least you're listening. That's good. Can you catch? Ah, look at that. I got one more. Now, this is M&M's. You got to give them up. Oh, it's Skittles. Okay. All right. Now, the story we talked about tonight is a true story in the Bible. Okay? You remember the story we talked about tonight? Remember it. Okay? After this guy comes to Jesus, what did Jesus tell him to do? Okay? That's what he said. That's exactly what he said. She got up pretty quick on that one. All right. Now, good job. We'll have some more tomorrow night. Now, listen to me. How many's been here every night? Listen to me. How many's been here every night? I've been here every night. Hallelujah. Praise God. Everybody else been here every night? Anybody else been here every night? I've been here every night. I've been here every night. Nettie's been here every night, but she ain't raising her hand. I don't know what's wrong with her. I've been here every night. Okay, kids, listen to this. If you come back tomorrow night, how are we going to do that? You tell me. Oh, yeah. You come back tomorrow night for your third night in a row, okay? If you come back tomorrow night, anybody that's been here three nights in a row, when you check in out here at the table, you tell them this is my third night. Now, they know whether you have been or not, okay? And they'll check it off. We're going to give you a ticket, okay? We're going to keep a ticket. And then we're going to draw them at the end. We're going to draw them at the end. Miles, come up here. sat down on that step right there. That's okay. I told you to hush. That's okay. See, that's what I do. I'm his papa. I can do that. All right? Now, listen. You come tomorrow night, three nights, we're going to give you a ticket, okay? And at the end of this Bible school, we're going to call that number off on your ticket. If you got the ticket, you get a big prize. How many we get? 1, 2, 3 prizes. Okay. We might have 4 prizes tomorrow night. We'll give them away. So, all right, would that be fun? Yeah. All right, okay, you want to holler praise the Lord again before we leave?
Yeah.
You do?
Yeah.
The girls against the boys?
Yeah.
You want to do it again? Let's do it again. All right. All right. Okay, somebody, Brother Chris, you up there? You got your, now he can go back with you. You got your handy dandy meter ready? All right. Handy dandy meter is ready. All right, ladies, you go first, okay? Ladies, you're first. And on count of three, what are you going to say?
Praise the Lord.
On count of three, what are you going to say?
Praise the Lord.
You better say it louder than that. On count of three. Okay. All right, that's good. Way to go, August. That was awesome, Gusta. That's awesome. You ready? Okay, ready? 1, 2, 3. Be seated. That was men, boys. We're going to need everybody we can get to help in this thing tonight, okay? All right? Come on, guys. Let's stand up. We're going to all praise the Lord. Come on, Brother Danny. You got to help us. We're outnumbered big time tonight. We're outnumbered. So we're real. Anthony, you're going to have to let it rip, son. We're depending on you. We're counting on you. Brother Dwayne, we need your help, son. We need your help. You got it? Brother Dwayne's got it. All right, here we go. Girls, you better sit down or we'll take that in that you're yelling for us. You ready? You ready, guys? Let's do it. Ready? Old Brother Dwayne's coming to help us too. We're going to do it. We're going to do it. Y'all ready? Abram, we're going to do it. I'm going to help you. You ready? 1, 2, 3. Okay, let's see what. I don't think it's close, is it?
It's not close tonight.
Not close tonight. Give the ladies a big hand. They got it. Good job, ladies. Listen, we're going to be dismissed in prayer. And how do we leave? How do we leave? We leave slow. We walk orderly. And the little ones go first. Okay? And no running. Mr. Danny, dismiss us in a word of prayer. Hey, we're praying. Brother Danny.
Health and the strength, Lord, we thank you for the kids that's come out, Lord, and the workers, Lord. We thank you for everyone that's been here and worked through this thing. And we thank you for the attentiveness of these kids, Lord, and the fun that they've had and the time that we've had with them, Lord. We pray, God, that you just let your Holy Spirit work in their hearts and everything that's been done and said toward the goal of basically leading them to the Lord. And we thank you for everything that you do. Bring us back tomorrow night safely. In Christ's name we pray.